So, another new productivity release at Microsoft Build 2020 this year was Microsoft Lists. Now, to be fair, you can't get this confused with Microsoft To Do. Lists is actually a different type of application. It's almost Airtable-like, and it is a new addition to Microsoft 365. So, what is Microsoft Lists? Now, Michaela Barrett, the program manager for OneDrive and Microsoft SharePoint, actually dives into this very well in her first look video. Microsoft Lists is a new app for businesses or teams that are looking to track issues, manage inventories, even itineraries, asset track, project planning, and much more. And they actually have a pretty good set of templates to get you started for a variety of scenarios. Now, the magic is when you can add some conditional formatting and a few rules or automations to create these mini workflows inside of Microsoft Lists. Now, in its nature and its action, Microsoft Lists is actually super similar to Airtable in both its look and its functionality. Now, before we move on to how this works a little bit more, this is currently going to be available via web in a new mobile application, and or within Microsoft Teams, which is set to have a very good integration with it. So, a little bit more of how it works. You can actually share your list with colleagues and give them access to editing, commenting, and reading. You can use conditional formatting to help you highlight specific tasks, and you can even comment and chat with teammates and even add more detail in each card. We're seeing a lot of different use cases, and Michaela in her video actually demonstrates how they are using it to plan out an itinerary for an upcoming business trip, associating tasks and items to certain people, but building a list that will help people navigate it in the future too. Now, there are three types of views that can express your data within lists. The first is a grid view, which is almost like gallery view inside of Airtable, a calendar view, which helps you to express the dates and times of all of your information, and a simple list view as well, which looks very similar to Excel. You can actually export to Excel too. And over the top of all of these different views, you can use filtering and sorting to get access to certain pieces of information. Now, just a note on the views, if you take the gallery view, or what they call the grid view, inside of this new Microsoft Lists, it looks incredibly similar to Chris Dancy's Airtable layout, especially when they demonstrate the asset or resource management. So the automation is built in too, allowing you to create very simple triggers out of activities. Like, for example, if somebody adds a certain entry, you could create a rule to notify a certain person. Now, this is actually something not completely new. They've got SharePoint lists that are fairly similar to this, although this takes it a step further, and there are some integrations that come into hand here. Now, according to Microsoft, this will be available later this summer, and it does seem like a lot is happening here for the end user. There seems to be a lot of tools trying to do the same sort of thing, but then again, if you're inside of Microsoft and you have been looking for a Airtable-like application that does a similar job to Airtable, then this could be the bet that you go with. So folks, hopefully that gave you a nice view overview of Microsoft Lists. If you're new here, please do subscribe. We just did a feature about Microsoft Fluid Framework too, so you can definitely check that out. And hopefully we'll try and cover some more Build 2020 features as well. Again, please do subscribe, like if you enjoyed, and I will talk to you guys in a future video. Thank you everyone, bye.